Hello and welcome to Candidates Forum 2021. My name is Ed Miller, your host, and we are pleased to be with Counselor at Large Moses Rodriguez. Moses, how are you doing today?
Very well. How are you doing, Ed?
Well, tell us a little about yourself and running for re-election of the council, some of the things that you might have done that you're proud of and you want to share with the constituents.
Well, Ed, as you know, I've been on the council now for 7.5 years. I'm someone who was born overseas. I came to this country as a teenager. I have lived in Brockton basically all my American life. I served in the United States Navy for 6 years, and I've been in Brockton ever since. Live here with my children, now a couple grandkids. As things move on and times change, and I'm honored to be a part of this city. As a matter of fact, I'm one of these individuals that always complain that we don't do a very good job in promoting what we have in this city. Mm-hmm. Often we hear people complain about the negative side of things versus focusing on the plus side of things. When you've got a high school that's larger than some towns in the county, you had to be proud of the fact that we've got that many kids running around in the halls of a school that are behaving the way they should behave. And that's something that we ought to be proud of and mm-hmm. be promoting of instead of just always focusing on the negative.
Okay. And what do you believe is the most important issue facing the city today?
Well, you know what? I believe, as I said, we all know that we've got some, a criminal aspect in the community. Public safety is a major issue. Mm-hmm. We know that education is always a major concern, but fortunately, we're getting some real dollars to invest in our school system. Hopefully, that will make some serious improvements, both in terms of additional personnel, but also in the infrastructure of the school itself. Mm-hmm. Being able to buy new books, being able to buy new technologies and stuff to provide to our kids. But I honestly believe that one of the number one issues that we have in this city is the lack of positive promotion of this city. Positive promotion, because when you do positive promotion of the city, what it does, it brings new businesses into the community to help the citizens out. It brings better living for everybody. It brings the change of the elements that basically you don't want in your community. Mm-hmm. That element will move on, go someplace else, and better people, more productive folks would stay behind. So I think one of the things that I see, to try to be different than everybody else, because it's easy to say, you want, public safety, you want education, you want this, you want that. Mm-hmm. Those are the basically beat conversations that you hear on a regular basis. But I think one of the things that we need to do is think outside of the box, build infrastructure that actually help the community out, build some facilities that our kids can go out and play, some fields and things like that. As a matter of fact, I just came from a meeting with the mayor and several other officials in the community talking about building athletic facilities, soccer, football, baseball, softball, some of these other things that will basically improve the quality of life for the kids in our community. And then you'll see some reduction in crime, some reduction in truancy, and some reduction in kids not doing the things that they should be doing. So that's what I think we ought to focus on.
Now, you mentioned public safety and a criminal aspect. Brockton being a city of 105,000 people, it doesn't seem like we're a crime-ridden city.
No.
Do we have a bigger issue than cities our size,
no,
or
we
do we have the regular issues?
No, we don't. I think that's one of the things that, when you see us being compared to the Avons of the world or the Stoughtons and the Eastons and so on and so forth, of course we've got the problems. But when you compare us to Boston, Worcester, Springfield, New Bedford, Fall River, we are one of the better school systems out of all these urban centers that we actually have in Massachusetts. So why is it that you're comparing us with Avon if Brockton High has more students than Avon has people? You can't, it's not even apples and oranges, it's apples and pineapples. Mm-hmm. So I think we need to compare apples with oranges or apples with apples, with the Bostons, the Worcesters, the Springfields, the New Bedford and the Fall Rivers, and now in the little not necessarily the little towns that surround us, because listen, in cities you're gonna have crime, some instances of crime. You're going to have some instances of prostitution. You're going to have some instances of, you know, people selling and buying drugs, because those are things that come along with cities. Right. Now, we can do something in terms of minimizing those efforts. You know, I mean, I remember when I was mayor in the city, we had, I brought in all the town managers of the surrounding communities, because the vast majority of the people that we have homeless in Brockton are not people from Brockton. They're coming from other communities because this is where the social services are. This is where you come looking for help. And when you come looking for help and you have no place to live, guess what? You become homeless in the streets of Brockton. I also found out that the vast majority of the, even the opioid overdoses are people who are here, transient folks that are coming from the other communities. They end up ODing or dying in the streets of Brockton that aren't necessarily from Brockton. So that's all a perceptional thing, you know, and that's what we need to kind of look at to change that perception, to accept the fact that we are a city of 105,000 people. And you've got towns that don't even have 5,000 people, never mind 105,000 people. So we got to change that whole thinking, that whole mentality of saying, you know, the town of Brockton. No, we're not a town of Brockton. We are a major city in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Right. We got the fourth largest school system in Massachusetts, which possibly means that we're the fourth largest community in Massachusetts. So it's important for us to put it into context, you know, not sit here and basically say, well, you know, look at the crime in this particular community versus this community. Yes, we've got some criminality that takes place in the city. Yes, we have some drug use and abuse in this community. But you know what? When you put us in perspective, comparing us to other communities of similar size, we're doing a lot better than most.
Now, as a ward counselor, or I'm sorry, as the counselor at large, I apologize, you have to vote on different bills that will hopefully improve the city. Mm-hmm. How would you react and how would you vote if you know something comes up that really could benefit the constituents and the city, but doesn't seem to be too favorable in the beginning with the constituents? How would you react to that? How would you vote on that?
Well, you know, we are unfortunately, or fortunately, a representative form of government. We represent the constituents, you know. Often, you put it out there, you get a sense. And again, but what's important for us to keep in mind is that we cannot be driven by the few loud ones, because that's what happens a lot of times in our community. Mm-hmm. You've got a small group of people, but they're loud ones that basically try to dominate the discourse, you know, the conversation.
Correct.
And you cannot sit here and decide on things that are for the good of the city of Brockton based on those handful of people. Now, if you've got an issue that you've got thousands of people against the issue, then you vote with the thousands. But if you have an issue that only has a small number of people against it, you got to look at it. Is it good for the city of Brockton? Does it help the city? And then vote accordingly. But you cannot sit here and be influenced by a handful of people who, and you know what, Ed? You know that as well as I do. Mm-hmm. There's some people, it doesn't matter if you say, well, it's beautiful out. You know what they're going to tell you? No, it's not. It could have been better. Well, look, it's sunny out. Well, it should be raining because we need the rain.
Right.
You know, well, it's raining out. Well, it should be sunny because we don't need any more rain. So there's always an opposite
side. It's always that contrary.
Yeah, there's always something contrary to whatever we're discussing. So you're always going to have those individuals that no matter how you look at it, they're going to be in the opposite side of things. So you got to do what's best for the global community, for the vast majority of the people in the community. Yeah, if the handful of the loud ones are pushing for or against an issue that the overall community do want or don't want, then you vote accordingly. Mm-hmm. But you gotta make sure that you don't get influenced by some of the ones that are constantly pushing an agenda, especially against this community. Mm-hmm. You know, that's what you gotta do.
Now, the next question is not under the purview of the council, but it's an issue that the council has to deal with. Mm-hmm. And it's not the most sexy what's affecting the city, but it is a concern of a lot of the constituencies. Mm-hmm. And now 3 years ago, we entered into a contract with waste management. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people are upset because even though they told their taxes didn't go up, they were charged in other ways. And one of the issues that a lot of people are having is the small size of the trash barrels. Where, and I have to say, a family of two people, just married, can't get all their trash into one of the bins. Can you imagine, and you having kids and grandkids, so you know that situation. The other one is that we have to use the Brockton bags, which is $4 for $5, and actually that went up 25%, where people could go buy just regular trash bags for $7 and get 30 in them. What are some of the problems when that contract comes up that you would feel that's going to benefit the city and benefit the constituents, I should say, which would benefit the city?
Well, you know, talking about the receptacle for the trash, actually when we first got those trash barrels, my grandson, who was probably about 3 years old or two, he thought we actually bought that for him to play with. Because it's really tiny when you sit down and think about it. I understand the logic behind it because we want people to recycle.
Yeah.
But we also know that we have three deckers. We have apartments in this community. We are a city. And cities usually tend to have families living in it. And families are three to five kids, plus a husband and wife. So you're looking at possibly seven or so people living in a single apartment or a single, single family home. So those containers are a little small. If I have anything to do with it, I'd increase the size of that barrel, of that particular barrel. But also at the same time, just kind of stay on top of recycling. Because people need to learn that there's a lot of things that we throw in the trash that could actually go in the recycling bin and get into that system. As far as the bags are concerned, now, we pay for trash. We, the city right, pays for trash. So if you open it up to a point where people can throw anything that they want to throw out, you know, go to the store and buy their black bags and pitch it, it's going to get out of control. You know, we have individuals now. You know, you drive by people's houses and you find people tossing mattresses on their front lawn because they don't want to pay for the disposal of the mattress. And then it becomes a problem for the resident that lives in that particular place. I get calls all the time for people saying, you know, I woke up this morning, there's a mattress on my lawn. What do I do with it? You know, we need to kind of get away from that particular stuff and give people perhaps a way out to be able to dispose of these large items without infringing on some other residents' rights as well. You know, the receptacle needs to get a little bit bigger because that was a little too small. But from what I understand, and Councillor Azak, I think, was part of that group, they put together a committee to look at this particular thing. And the residents that showed up voted on that small receptacle. You know, again, you believe in democracy. Sometimes it doesn't come out the way we always want. But at the time, it was decided by those folks on that focus group. That's what they decided on in terms of the trash receptacle. So you got to go by the wishes and the wills. Other people didn't show up when they had a chance to basically pronounce how they feel about it. So those that showed up voted on that, and that's what we're living with. If I have an opportunity, I'll ask to increase it a little bit because I know the trouble that families like mine and others go through with trash. So if we can improve it, why not?
We have time for one more question. And the question is that a lot of small business owners, and especially first-time business owners, are having issues when they have to get through City Hall and get all the correct permits. A lot of the construction people and plumbers who've talked to me have said, if it takes me days in another city to get the permits, it takes me weeks here. If it takes me weeks, it's months. And it becomes an expense, they're losing money. What are some of the changes you feel as a councilor you can bring working with the mayor, because they are under the mayor's purview, to speed up the process and make Brockton a more business-friendly community?
We have to do that, Ed. We have to do that because I hear that complaint about all the time. I heard it when I was the mayor. I hear it now. We hear it all the time. So you know what? We got to do better than that. We got to do better than that. Join the 21st century, improve the things that we need to do. I mean, when I got there, they were still using paper, you know, paper permits and paper this, paper that. We're slowly moving the process up where somebody can actually apply for things online, but we got to do a lot better than that. And the mayor and some of the committees that I've talked to or some folks that I've talked to have basically decided that it's something that we need to do. We're going to work together to kind of make that happen, hopefully real soon.
Moses Rodriguez, who is running for re-election, counselor at large, thank you for coming down. And don't forget, November 2nd is Election Day, the most important day that we have because this is how we chose who's going to run our city. Very important. Please get out and vote. My name is Ed Miller. Thank you for listening, and I hope you have a great day.